beautiful Cancerian astrology soulmates. Welcome to your horoscope for July of 2020. We're Cancer this month. I got to tell you, as I looked over the horoscope, we've had high eclipse time. So lots of activation of your ruling planet's energy, lots of moon energy, right? It's been going on. It's been hitting you. I'm sure you've been in the mix of feeling it and feeling the adjustments that are being made to your world. But this month, very specifically, one of the things that comes to my mind as I look at this next eclipse that's going to be happening in the energy of Capricorn, as well as the fact that Saturn is going to take its retrograde back into the energy of Capricorn, everything is looking straight across the street at you, right? So it's relationships, and it's the balance of Cancerian relationships in terms of what do you need and what do other people need. You don't want this area to be out of balance. It can't be all everybody else. It can't be all you. So this month, as adjustments are being made in relationships, I think it's really bringing to your table the crystallized and refined attitude and actions of how are you going to handle these things is really something that I think is on your table this month. As well, we come into the month with Mars in the energy of Aries, where he's going to be for quite some time. So we've got movement and action and energy happening up at the top of your chart. So things with work for you, but also things in the career / what I'm doing in the world arena are going to be happening for other people as well. And that may bring something to your table to, again, need to demonstrate with crystal clarity, how are you going to do this? How are you going to handle these situations in very mature ways? So I think it's definitely a good month. It's going to be a busy month. There's movement going on for sure. And you will certainly have no opportunity to be bored this month, okay? Now, one other thing I want to say before we actually jump into the forecast itself is that Venus is out of retrograde this month and rolling back there through your 12th house. So this actually brings a fair amount of financial clarity to your table. And I also think that it brings a fair amount of relationship clarity to the table because you're thinking and you're able to see things that maybe you couldn't see before. You're able to do a little research, maybe even a little digging into things in the 12th house arena. And you really have a very clear grasp of the information, despite the fact that Mercury is in retrograde in your sign as we come into this month. That, I think, is giving you more of the space and the position to be reevaluating you, rethinking, are your needs being met? Are you meeting the needs of people around you? Where are you at in the balance of relationships? Are there hidden motives? Are you doing what you need to do in the quiet, hidden places to take care of Cancerian energy? So I definitely think that you have a lot of clarity that comes with that Venus being out of retrograde. Okay, let's jump in and let's talk about what's happening this month. Right at the very beginning of the month on July 1st, we see Saturn taking that retrograde on the road. He is moving it backwards from the energy of Aquarius and moving it into the energy of Capricorn. Now, this is going to light up your seventh house. The seventh house is conscious, chosen relationships, one-on-one relationships, how we're interacting here. Now, as Saturn comes back, the thing we want to be mindful of is it's not coming back to something new. We've been looking at this area, Cancer, for some time, right? This has been on the agenda. You've been working on relationships, committed relationships, specifically relationships of you and you, relationships of how you're going to go out in the world and do business. That has been a very big one, I think. Either way, relationships have been called into your life. This isn't new. You've been working on them, right? And the ones that were not meant to fit, you've been letting those go. The right ones that are the good ones, you've been allowing those to come back in as well. But as Saturn brings this retrograde back to the table, it's going to say, all right, Cancer, in the area and arena of your relationships, where do you need to bring some self-discipline back to the table? And have you mastered how to do this? Where do you need to get more organized? Where do you need to look at where when you really show up and own what's happening in your relationships, you're actually granted freedom on the other side because you know, like the left hand and the right hand both know what's going on. So clarity in relationships shows up here as well. Then on the 5th of July, we see this full moon lunar eclipse happening in the energy of Capricorn as well. So this keeps the focus in the home front on that seventh house, which by proxy shines it back on you, Cancer. So it's really a big time right here as we travel through July that says, Cancer, what are you doing? What are you doing in your life? What are you doing in your relationships? Where are you making those moves? And where are you being accountable for making the moves, making the relationship stronger, investing more, things like that. That all comes to the table. But this full moon says that something has to be ended, acknowledged, and adjusted. Right? Now, because it's an eclipse, we know that we're going to be making these adjustments for the next 6 months. So I can tell you, truly, in terms of relationships, if they are relationships that have cracks in the cement, you're going to, all of the business is going to come to the light over the next 6 months. And if you need to air your grievances, you need to do whatever you need to do. Sometimes you got to have a breakdown before you have a breakthrough in relationships, right? That's sometimes the beauty of these things. But the ones that are fundamentally flawed, maybe we'll pass off of the scene. So I think that that is a wonderful adjustment to come to your table, but it also makes space too, where it's like, if the relationship of you with you has some flaws in it, you can go ahead and get those uncovered and out of the way here as well. Now, this eclipse is going to gently brush over Mercury, Jupiter, and Mars energy. So for me, this is the other part that comes in, is I do think in terms of relationships, like, something is happening for someone you are in relationship with, whether that be romantically, business, friendship, whatever it is, and then it's bringing things back to your table, and you have to decide how much you get involved with that, right? You have to decide how much you let somebody else take on what they need to take on, or is this the right place? Is this the best place for Cancer to step in? So really, how much do you bring to the table to maybe solve someone else's problem or to help them or to invest? There's a fair amount of intimacy here, but there's certainly going to be some career adjustment happening that could be from someone else that impacts you, okay? On the 11th, we see Chiron, our wounded healer, heading into retrograde until December. Now, Chiron is that hole in our soul, our wound, the place that we hurt, and we know the depth of that hurt, right? In the energy of Aries, this very much so has to do with identity, what I think about myself. For you, Cancer, this is in the area of career. What am I doing? What am I offering out to the world? Am I living my passion? Am I living with some sort of depth, right? Am I being the warrior and accepting that I have something good to offer out to the world? Is my name solid in my workplace, or have I created kind of a weird reputation for myself? These are questions in the out there world that I think we get to go back over and really address if you're owning who you are as well. Are you accepting yourself as whole and valid and complete right now today as you are? Because from that perspective of the truth that you just are what you are today, that's the only place to trudge and move forward and to make a real impact, not from any vision that's what you expect yourself to be at this point in your life, but simply what you are today and where you can work from there. Now, on the 12th, we see Mercury coming out of retrograde right there in your sign, so first house. So this is great. Mercury out of retrograde. Now, before we get all excited about Mercury getting out of retrograde and we're like, yes, I'm going to make all these decisions, I'm going to do all of this traveling, I'm going to do all of this stuff, just give Mercury a couple days to unwind, unfurl, get his life together, and to also resume that orbit. So then you can make some decisions that are emotionally intelligent. Right? You're making some emotionally based decisions for yourself, for your life, for what's best for you. Is this the best relationship for you? Is this the best job for you? Am I living in the place that feeds my soul, that I'm able to feed other people by my being here as well? It is emotionally intelligent because Mercury is here. So it's a pretty solid, grounded move that'll be coming in. And oops, I'm getting, somebody needs to call their mom. Okay, look, I don't know who you are, but you need to call your mom. Okay, that just came through very clear. So if that is you and you need to call mama, please put that in the comment section down below so that I know you got your message, because I don't want your mom calling me saying I didn't tell you, okay? So as Mercury is out of retrograde here in all Cancerian affairs, now you can take these steps forward, sign those contracts, commit yourselves to relationships, commit yourself to decisions at work, commit yourself to travel and these kinds of things, okay? As we round out and end this month, the sun is going to be moving right into the energy of Leo. So this is going to light up your second house. Again, I think this speaks beautifully to some financial clarity that you have, or value clarity, right? This is a lot of value clarity happening here, where you're like, I know my worth. I know what I'm doing. I know the line between where I need to help out and provide and where you need to stand up and provide, especially since this is in regards to relationship. But the sun coming here to the second house brings light, heat, life and vitality. So your second house of earnings in general could really be beautifully activated at this particular time. So enjoy it. Leo likes the joy, likes the pleasure, likes the play in this particular area. So around your money, even with the things that you own, are you playing? Are you interacting with that really cool motorcycle that you bought? Are you playing and interacting with these people around you? Whatever it is, and ooh, are you playing? Are you being creative? Are you sharing some skills that you have? Maybe even some resources, honestly, in a very creative way with someone who is in one of these critical relationships that is in your life at this time. Either way, this Leo energy is really vibing up a lot of creativity and a lot of play and a lot of joy in this area. So truly, I guess you could be spending your money to go visit someone you're in relationship with who for some reason is just, there's distance between the two of you at this time, but it could definitely be financially beneficial for you both at this particular time as well. All right, Cancer, I think it's going to be a good month. You do have plenty of things working for you. Please remember this month, because it is another eclipse and the moon does rule you, to make sure you are resting. You're not overcommitting so that you're overtired. You're hydrating. You're moving your body. Do the things that you need to be safe, sane, healthy, and well, okay? All right, you guys, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. The solstice gifts are still available. And I look forward to seeing you this month in the Eat and Greets. We've got plenty of friends coming to the table, starting off the month with Tony Howard being here talking about out of bounds planets. So I can't wait to catch you for that and all of the rest of the Eat and Greets that are happening this month as well. All right, you guys, I love you. See you next month.